Hey, peace, family. Class is in session. So let's talk about the foundational principle. The first thing that we all must do in order to build long-term family intergenerational wealth, right? So we've talked about in future and in previous sessions what wealth is. Well, let's talk about the first principle we have to do in order to build that intergenerational legacy and wealth. The first thing is that you must do and your family must do is you must establish a family patriarch or matriarch, or what we call the CEO of your last name. So let's break that down and define what a CEO is, right? A CEO is the chief executive officer of an organization, right? The chief executive officer is defined as the leader and visionary of an organization. So let's take your last name. It might be Jones, it might be Robinson, it might be Rogers, right? It may be Garcia, it may be Morrison, right? Let's take your last name. In order for that last name to be intentional, meaning on purpose, and to about building its legacy and intergenerational wealth, somebody has to take charge to set a vision out for the family and to lead the family and to prepare him or herself and equip him or herself with enough information, enough strategies, tools, and resources to not just be CEO because it's the macho thing to do and I'm the man, so follow me, or I'm the woman of the house and I held it down, so follow me. No, you've earned the right to be the patriarch or matriarch because you know more or have committed to know more than everyone else and to lead the family. So when you have that level of intentionality from a chief executive officer of the Morrison last name and Morrison legacy, you earn the respect of other family members by the work you put in, and now you set out a blueprint and a plan for how do we as Morrisons build intergenerational legacy and family wealth. Then you begin the journey of creating cash for the family. Well, you take a step back and say, if this is what legacy is, the amount of assets or wealth or cash one leaves behind for their heirs, how do we again back that thing up and reverse engineer and work backwards from that picture? So as a family CEO, I'm thinking, well, if legacy is the amount of cash, assets, and wealth we leave behind for our heirs, and wealth is an abundance of cash that supersedes liability and debt, then my job as a family CEO is to make sure that we are creating cash through different entrepreneur ventures, taking our work income and making it work for us. I'm making sure that we're keeping the cash. That's through mindset, through budgeting, P&Ls, and credit, good credit and debt and leverage. But then that we're growing the cash through passive streams of income, multiple streams of income, other hustles, other investments, and that we're protecting the cash so that no one can get it and we're not paying it all to Uncle Sam and that it's insured, and then that we're passing it on to our defined heirs through estate planning. So that's my job as the CEO, to learn about those five principles and who and what I need to execute that, to work backwards, reverse engineer from what a legacy is defined as, right? And so that's your job as your family CEO, patriarch or matriarch, is to prepare yourself to fill in the holes of those five principles on the legacy wheel. And if you are intentional about that, and you work together as a family unit to pull those things together, be more financially responsible, take on good debt, keep a family P&L, look at leverage opportunities, create cash out of thin air through strategies like real estate wholesaling and other brokerage strategies, grow cash through passive income strategies, use tax mitigation and insurance as a way to protect your wealth, and have intentional estate planning, you are guaranteed to leave a better legacy for your family than the one you inherited. Doesn't mean it's going to be a $10 million, $100 million, a multi-million dollar legacy, but if it's a $100,000 legacy and it's more than the blank that you inherited, you should be proud of yourself. So with that, that's the motivation, inspiration, and directions on how you become the best CEO of your last name. Class is now out of session. I thank you guys for participating in our detention center. Right, you're in detention right now because you've been bad. You haven't been the best. neither have I. So we're in detention together, but we're going to learn during this detention, and we're going to leave out of it better students. So guys, make sure you like this video, comment, give me your feedback. Certainly subscribe to our channels for more content just like this, but also share so the world can hear these positive messages and get these vibrations of what legacy looks like and really get the instructions on how they can accomplish it. So I'll be still here in detention. I'll see you in our next lesson in class. Make sure you guys read your notes, practice your notes, and continue to be the best CEOs of your last name.